Good morning, respected Father Crispino, Miss Meena, Miss Anita, all our teachers and beloved friends.
A day without prayer is a day without blessing, and life without prayer is life without power. We would now like to begin our assembly by reciting the Lord's Prayer, requesting Krishna to lead us in prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
In our request, Avishai Lasrado to sing the national anthem and Kyumi Jain to recite the pledge. Kindly stand.
Janagana mana adhinayaka jaya he Bharat bhagya vidata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravid Utkal Banga Vindhya Himachal Yamuna Ganga Uchchal Jaladi Taranga शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभाशिष मागे गाए तव जय गाता जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विदाता जय जय
India is my country. All Indians are my brothers and sisters. I love my country and I am proud of its rich and varied heritage. I shall always strive to be worthy of it. I shall give my parents, teachers and all elders respect and treat everyone with courtesy. To my country and my people, I pledge my devotion. In their well-being and prosperity alone lies my happiness.
Thank you, Avishai and Kyumi. I now hand over to Prisha and Vrisha to share with us the news for the day.
National news. 16 prisoners managed to escape from Jodhpur jail by throwing red chili powder on the guards. New Maharashtra Home Minister promises no political interference. Hours after taking charge as the Maharashtra Home Minister, senior NCP leader Dilip Wills Patil has said that he will work to strengthen the image of the police force and will ensure no political interference. 12.7 million COVID cases detected, 11.7 million recovered, and 166,000 deaths. These cases totaled 5th April. WHO denies issuing warning in 50,000 COVID-19 deaths in India by 15th April, says it's fake news. International news. Rescuers hunt for survivors after cyclone kills 119 in Indonesia. Amid high tensions, China warns America against taking superior position on global affairs. Australian and New Zealand residents will be able to travel between the two nations without having quarantine from 19th April onwards. This move was announced by the New Zealand Prime Minister on Tuesday.
Sports news. IPL starts from 9th April. Real Madrid bashes Liverpool in a 3-1 victory. Barcelona defeats Valladolid 1-0. DBIS news. 13th and 14th April are holidays for Gudi Padwa and Ambedkar Jayanti respectively. Summatives begin from 23rd April. Senior KG graduation is on 30th April.
Our topic is World Health Day. Although we think we know everything about this day, there is still a lot to learn. I now request Naisha to share her insights on the same.
World Health Day isn't all about hand washing and healthy care eating. It is a day observed worldwide by government and non-government health organizations, focusing on promoting healthier living habits that increase the life expectancy of people around the world. There are organized activities, pledges, and support plans such as conferences for health workers. This special day has become a collective action aimed globally at protecting mental health and physical human health and well-being for all ages.
Thank you, Naisha. We now have Suhani, Varnika, Vanshika, Avishai, Savion, Trisha, and Pranay, who will present a short skit on the importance of physical health.
This girl has been bullied at school for how scrawny she is. Every day her friends judge her. She is faced with mean comments by her peers that are rude and nasty. Comments like,
"Oh my gosh, don't you eat anything? Ugh, you're so scrawny."
Every day she comes home with tears in her eyes. Her friends make her feel there's something wrong with her. She tries to gain weight by eating more food than she wants to, but her weight never seems to increase. Every day, she finds herself checking her weight, but is always dismayed as her weight stays the same and never increases.
Avishai is a college girl who has always dreamed of being an Insta sensation like her inspiration, Charlie D'Amelio. She started an account where she posted several videos, but right now, just that was at a mere 100 followers. That's just friends and family. But the worst part was that several people commented negatively. Of course, she wasn't unhealthy or over excessively fat, but she definitely wasn't lean. But that drink she just had and those tablets, that protein shake, and she's dangerously allergic to it. That is why she takes those tablets. But they are too strong and can horribly damage her liver. And that bandage, guess who's been overexerting herself with all that exercise?
Hey there, how are you?
Good, oh my god, you've grown so much taller and muscular, how did you do that?
Yes, I have. I've been taking these extra proteins and other supplements.
Wow, interesting. How did you get to know about this?
So, I was just watching an ad on YouTube and then this ad showed up saying, take these pills and you will grow much taller and muscular.
Where did you get them from?
The same website has a store link. You could order it from there.
But how much would that cost?
It's very cheap. It costs just ₹99. And you can get taller and muscular.
But don't you think these could cause side effects?
Why do you bother about the side effects? Don't you want to look better?
I do, but I'm scared.
Don't you trust me?
I do, but...
Then why don't you listen to me?
It's not like that, but I'm not sure. Maybe I shouldn't.
Okay then, your wish. But then you do not need to be part of my group and hang out with my friend.
No, don't say that. I want to have as many friends as you. Okay, fine. We will meet tomorrow and we'll order this together, okay?
Now that's like my body. See you after school.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
The scenarios you just watched clearly depict that people today exercise and try to become fitter or rather thinner only to fit in or because they're forced to. Nowadays, people have started gaining momentum and popularity on various social media platforms on the basis of their looks rather than their personality. This is not right. People starve themselves and make their health suffer only to lose those few kgs of weight and all of this so they can fit into the society. This is not done. You should exercise only to take care of your body and for your satisfaction, not others. It doesn't matter what others think of you. It's what you think of yourself that really counts. Being healthy is more than maintaining a zero figure. It's more than getting those likes and comments on Instagram. Health is a real wealth, not bits of gold and silver. Thank you.
That was truly insightful. We now present to you a short panel discussion by Arush, Anahita, Ishil, Naisha, Ashna, Priyana, and Jia about the importance of mental health.
Mental health includes our emotional, psychological, and social well-being. It affects how we think, feel, and act. It also helps determine how we handle stress, relate to others, and make choices. Mental health is important at every stage of life, from childhood and adolescence through adulthood. Over the course of your life, if you experience mental health problems, your thinking, mood, and behavior could be affected. Mental disorders are among the most common causes of disability. The resulting disease burden of mental illness is among the highest of all diseases. In any given year, an estimated 18.1%, 43.6 million people of US adults aged 18 years or older suffer from a mental illness, and 4.2%, 9.8 million people suffer from a serious mental illness. Suicide is the 10th leading cause of death in the United States, accounting for the deaths of approximately 43,000 Americans in 2014. Mental health and physical health are closely connected. Mental health plays a major role in people's ability to maintain good physical health. Mental illnesses such as depression and anxiety affect people's ability to participate in health-promoting behaviors. In turn, problems with physical health, such as chronic diseases, can have a serious impact on mental health and decrease a person's ability to participate in treatment and recovery.
In simple words, depression is a constant feeling of sadness, hopelessness, and loss of interest, which stops you from doing your normal activities. It is most common among people aged 18 to 29, and compared to men, women are more likely to go through this mood disorder. Globally, more than 264 million people of all ages suffer from depression. Usually, depression occurs because of many factors or events in a person's life, like personal problems with family or friends, major life events like moving or graduating, past abuse, stress, etc. Sometimes, genes can also be a cause of depression. For example, if a parent or other family member had depression, the child might also go through depression. Aggressiveness, anxiousness, feeling sad or hopeless, the inability to concentrate, change in sleep patterns, fatigue, and headaches are some common symptoms of depression. Things like medication, therapy, exercising, and most importantly, talking about your issues are effective ways to overcome depression. And to avoid it, having a good lifestyle and self-confidence is needed.
Anxiety is an emotional state where we feel uneasiness and worry for an anticipated event or circumstance in the future. Generally, the source of anxiety is unfocused and there is a generic sense of apprehension and wariness that accompanies anxiety. While the source of anxiety is vague and subjective, the harmful effects of the same on our body are not. Anxiety leads to restlessness, irritability, fatigue, lack of concentration, muscular tension, and even depression. Though anxiety can't be cured permanently, it can be managed through a mix of change in lifestyle, therapy, and medication. Most importantly, recognition that is one prone to anxiety and is therefore needs to control his or her reaction to situations is important. Second, cognitive behavioral therapy has been found to be extremely helpful in helping treat and control anxiety. Finally, there are medications available that can help in managing the anxiety levels. In conclusion, anxiety is an easy to manage mental health condition. Acceptance and recognition of this as a medical condition is the first and most important step towards finding help and managing it effectively in your life.
A few causes of mental illnesses can be childhood abuse or sexual assault. Since social isolation or loneliness can cause mental illnesses. Since the period of COVID-19, the rates of people developing mental illnesses have increased massively. That too only counting the people who have visited a psychologist or a psychiatrist. Many people don't share what's going on inside their head. Another reason can be experiencing discrimination and stigma on a daily basis. Poverty or debt and severe long-term stress are also very common causes of depression and anxiety. Most scientists believe that mental illnesses result from problems with the communication between the neurons and the brain. For example, the level of the neurotransmitter serotonin is low in individuals who have depression. This finding led to the development of certain medications for the illness. Changes in the brain chemistry from substance abuse or changes in the diet can also cause mental disorders. Psychological factors and environmental factors such as upbringing and social exposure can form the foundations for harmful thought patterns associated with mental disorders.
Mental illness, also called mental health disorders, refers to a wide range of mental health conditions. Disorders that affect your mood, thinking, and behavior. Examples of these symptoms include feeling sad or down, confused thinking or reduced ability to concentrate, excessive fears or worries, or extreme feelings of guilt, extreme mood changes of highs and lows, withdrawal from friends and activities, significant tiredness, low energy or problems, detached from reality, paranoia or hallucinations, inability to cope with daily problems or stress, trouble understanding and relating to situations and to people, problems with alcohol or drug use, major changes in eating habits, excessive anger, hostility or violence, suicidal thinking. Sometimes symptoms of a mental health disorder appear as physical problems, such as stomach pain, back pain, headaches, or other unexplained aches and pains.
Depression is a constant feeling of sadness and loss of interest, which stops you from doing your normal activities. The treatment for depression is usually medication or therapy. Your doctor or psychiatrist can prescribe medications to relieve symptoms. Many people with depression also benefit from seeing a psychiatrist, psychologist, or other mental health professionals. People with severe depression may need a hospital stay or may need to participate in an outpatient treatment program until the symptoms improve. Therapy can also be provided as a computer program by online sessions or using videos or workbooks. Anxiety is a feeling of worry, nervousness, or unease about something with an uncertain outcome. Once you've been diagnosed with anxiety, you can explore treatment options with your doctor. Many doctors prescribe antidepressants for anxiety. Therapy is another option. Psychotherapy is counseling that helps you learn about your emotions and how they affect your behaviors. A mental health specialist listens to you talk about your thoughts and feelings and suggests ways to understand and manage them. Here are some other things you should do to treat anxiety. Get better sleep, eat right, exercise, and cut down on foods and drinks that contain caffeine.
There are more popular mental diseases other than depression and anxiety, such as psychosis, autism, paranoia, schizophrenia, bipolar disorder, and traumatic stress disorder. You must be thinking, why is mental health serious? Well, mental illness such as depression and anxiety affect people's ability to participate in health promoting behaviors. In turn, problems with physical health such as chronic diseases can have serious impact on mental health and decrease a person's ability in treatment and recovery. People with mental illness also tend to remove people from their life, which isn't beneficial for them. Their interaction and motivation are decreased and their thoughts become extremely toxic, which leads to committing suicide.
Mental health is not spoken about very often. Today, through our assembly, we want to convey the message that it is okay not to be okay. Mental health is not a taboo. We should learn to have more open conversations about mental health. we should realize that there is always light at the end of the tunnel, irrespective of the obstacles. We would like to end our assembly with a song that signifies hope. Here's presenting The Climb by Miley Cyrus.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. It ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. Struggles I'm facing, the chances I'm taking, sometimes might knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know it, but these are the moments that I'm gonna remember most, yeah. Just gotta keep going.
Understood the importance of World Health Day and will take good care of your health, both physical and mental. I now request Father Crispino, Father Orwell, and Miss Meena to share their thoughts.
Good morning to everyone present here for the assembly. And congratulations to the two teachers. I think there is Nigel and Shannon, the two teachers of the seventh grade who have come together to put up this assembly. Thanks to all the students who have taken active part in this assembly. And I think it is a very pertinent topic on health that they have chosen, because just yesterday we celebrated World Health Day. You know, if there is one thing that has really made me reflect on this year, especially after my injury, I'm sure all of you are aware that I broke my Achilles tendon whilst playing basketball. And it was not because I'm getting old or anything, it was because I neglected my health. And when I went to the doctor, the first thing that the doctor asked me is, what is your sugar level, which I had not checked for the last 4 years. No. And then I realized that it was very high. And he said, this is one of the main reasons why you got the injury. So when we don't look after our health, no, when we don't look after our bodies and our minds, then we are faced with all sorts of problems. No. And I like particularly what Arush Kamdar said in the panel discussion when he started. He said there is a connection between physical health and mental health. You know, so if our minds are strong, then we can take care of our bodies. And if our bodies are strong, it will take care of our minds. So the two things go hand in hand. I really like to wish all of us in the school, staff and students, and also the parents, good health, both in mind and body. Because you can have all the possible wealth, but if you don't have health, you will not be able to enjoy your wealth. No. So that is the paradox of life. Yeah. Wealth is useless without good health. And we spend all our life collecting wealth, but we forget to look after our health. So good morning to all of you and have a nice day.
Do I speak now?
Yes, Pat.
Good morning. I was quite impressed by your assembly and the focus that you gave us in these trying times on our health. And my suggestion is that we also, together with physical health and mental health, we also think of emotional health as well as spiritual health. You know, it all goes together. We are strengthened, we are enlivened when we think about this globally. When I get up in the morning, the first thing I thank God is that I have health, that I'm alive, and I have good health to get up from my bed and move around. See, these are gifts God has given us. So, spiritual health, mental health, physical health, as well as emotional health. And what I liked about this assembly is the fact that you concluded saying that it is an uphill task. It is not easy. We are all lazy by nature. We don't want to exercise. And this exercise must be in all fields, emotionally, physically, mentally, as well as spiritually. There must be some exercises that goad us on, that push us on. And in all this, you must know your body. Or else what happened, something happens to you and you go to the doctor, they prescribe some medicine and it has side effects. So you must know your body, keep yourself healthy. When I looked at the class, I saw many of you wearing specs. Even at this age, I've been just operated for both my eyes and I'm wearing specs. But to see you wearing specs at this age, you need to do some, maybe some eye exercises or something like that. and be healthy. Your eyes are precious. Your health is precious. I thank you for this awareness that you have given us, and I wish all of you good health. Live well. God bless.
Good morning, Father, teachers, and my dear students. Thank you, Nigel sir and Shannon sir, for that wonderful assembly telling us the importance of health, whether it's mental health or physical health. And I think Don Bosco is the place which has been talking about your physical health all the time. The reason that we started the sports program in the midst of the pandemic, when we couldn't have you in school, was why we realized, the reason for it was the importance of staying fit. And the pandemic has also taught us one thing, that only the fit can survive this pandemic. If you have no comorbidities, you can get over some of the symptoms of COVID quite easily without getting hospitalized, just because you're fit. And many of these comorbidities which they talk about are lifestyle related diseases. One is A, physical fitness, which we talk about, and B is the food that we have. We have to see that we eat food which is in just right for our body and not excess. The excess calories that we take only lead into fat accumulation, which is obesity. And the second thing is it also leads to other lifestyle related diseases like blood pressure, cholesterol problems, and diabetes. You must be thinking, why am I speaking about all this at this age? You're still young. But this is the time when all the extra food that you eat, which your body doesn't require, and if you do not exercise, it will only boil down to what it will lead to in the future. So be conscious about this, children, and stay fit. Now I know we've stopped everything in school, but whatever way in which you can stay fit, whether it's a few skipping exercises or walking or some little bit of training, which we do in the online classes, continue doing that and stay fit. It's very, very important for your well-being and for our well-being. Also, when we talk about mental health, we do have Ms. Bindu and Ms. Upasana in school. I know you all gave the reference numbers, but maybe at the end of it, we could add Ms. Bindu's and Ms. Upasana's email ID. Or you can reach out to any of the coordinators or your own HRT if you want to talk to any of them. I know you are not in school, so reaching out may not be very easy at the moment. But reach out to any of us. We'll get you in touch with Ms. Bindu and Ms. Upasana, who can help you if you feel that any of those symptoms which were discussed in the panel discussion is what is bothering you at this time. Now, coming back to what we spoke about, what's happening in the school children, the number of teachers at the moment who have been infected with COVID, and so have their families. So it may happen that the classes may not be as planned always. There would be little changes because of the teachers not being well. So please bear with us. Yes, we'll make sure that what is planned will be done before the exams begin, but there would be slight changes. Pray for your teachers and their families. And of course, we also pray for your families that you all have good health and COVID doesn't touch any of you. So as of now, our exams are on schedule, which we just spoke about in the school news, beginning on the 23rd of April. 1 week prior to that, the portions will be done. And if for any reason there is any change, the change will be told to you and will be shared on Manage Back. All the best, children. Start preparing for your exams. There are no co-curricular activities at this point of time, so you can in earnest start preparing for the final examination. And what comes in the paper, that all students will be promoted to grade 8 without exam, is not for DBIS, that is for the state board exams. We have been conducting our exams on exam.net, and that will continue for now. Have a nice day and all the best for your exams.
Thank you, Father Crispy, though. Thank you, Father Orwin. Thank you, Miss Meena.
Before we end, we'd like to say a big thank you to Miss Anita for guiding us and supporting us. Thank you to the IT department for always being so helpful. Thanks to everyone who joined and witnessed our assembly. Have a great day ahead.